الله أوله وآخره. The second thing I want to speak about is that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّا عَلَيْنَا جَمَعَهُ وَقُرْآنَا, O Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, it is our responsibility to bring all the parts of the Quran together as one complete whole. And then it is our responsibility to recite it to you. فَإِذَا قَرَأْنَاهُ فَاتَّبِعْ قُرْآنَا. And when we have recited the Quran, you must follow that way of recitation. This I've already explained to you. But then what's the next verse? The next verse after that is ثُمَّ إِنَّ عَلَيْنَا بَيَانَهُ. Then it is our responsibility to explain the Quran. So the first step on the road of the Quran, the first step is to recite. The second step in the study of the road of the Quran is to understand what you're reciting. Allah explains the Quran. And therefore, we need to have not only the proper methodology for reciting the Quran, but also the proper methodology for study of the Quran. The Quran is not a book which is arranged in such a way that you begin at the beginning and you study chapter by chapter until the end. No. Allah has not arranged the Quran in such a way for study. He says in Suratul Isra, listen, Quranan faraknahu litakrahu ala nas, that I have separated the Quran into surahs, plural of surah suwar. I have separated the Quran in the surahs not for study. No, I have separated the Quran into surahs for the purpose of recitation. So you don't study the Quran by beginning with Suratul Fatiha and then studying Suratul Baqarah and then studying Suratul Ali Imran and then Suratul Nisa. That is not the way. You recite the Quran that way. That's the way. This subject has been explained in my book, The Quran and the Moon. But the study of the Quran is different. Allah speaks in Surah Al-Waqia. I remember I was a young student and I went to my teacher, Maulana Fadlur Rahman Ansari. It was in Pakistan at the Ademia Institute of Islamic Studies. And he had just performed the Salatul Asr. And he was standing in front of the masjid talking to someone. And I went to him and I asked politely whether I could ask a question. I asked more questions to my teacher than all the rest of the students combined. But he was never impatient with me. Oh, he showed a lot of patience with me. So I asked him, why does Allah say in the beginning that this Quran provides guidance for those who fear Allah? Hudal lil muttaqin. I said, what about the rest? And then he looked up at the sky and he said, look at the stars up there in the sky. And then he taught me the lesson that you have to study the Quran the way you study the stars. But he didn't tell me, but Imran, this is there in the Quran, in Suratul Waqia. In Suratul Waqia, Allah speaks and he says, بَعْدَ أُوْزِ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ فَلَا أُقْسِمُ بِمَوَاقِعِ النُّجُومِ. And I take an oath, a qasam, by the مَوَاقِعِ النُّجُومِ, the positions in which the stars are located in the sky. This is an oath that Allah has taken, a qasam. And then he goes on to say, وَإِنَّهُ لَقَسَّمٌ لَوْ تَعَلَمُونَ عَظِيمٌ. This is a tremendously important oath which I have taken, Qasam, by the positions in which the stars are located. What is this connected with? إِنَّهُ لَقُرْآنٌ كَرِيمٌ فِي كِتَابٍ مَكْنُونَ. I have taken this oath about the positions in which the stars are located because this is connected with the Qur'an al-Kareem, the noble Qur'an, the generous Qur'an, which is located in a kitab. Qur'an means recitation. So this recitation called the Qur'an is located in a book which is protected. لَا يَمَسُّهُ إِلَّا الْمُتَحَّرُونَ. To study this book, the study of this book is connected with the stars, and the connection between the different stars is not based only, you do not study the stars and understand the connection between the stars based only on your rational faculty. It's also on the basis of knowledge that Allah gives to you, insight. And unless the heart is clean and pure, meaning the heart is faithful to Allah, you will not be able to even touch the meaning of this Qur'an. Tell that to Washington for me. Tell that to all those who are waging war on Islam. You cannot even penetrate this Qur'an as much as to touch it, unless your heart, your pagan heart, your diseased heart, your decadent heart, is cleansed and it turns faithfully to Allah, you cannot even touch this Qur'an for understanding it. And so the methodology for study of the Qur'an is critically important. And it is based like the stars, you have to understand how the different verses of the Qur'an are connected with each other. And for this I have already written the book, Methodology for Study of the Qur'an. This is what I leave behind me when I go from this world. Methodology for recitation of the Qur'an, methodology for study of the Qur'an. And I got this from my teacher, of blessed memory. The Prophet said, he said that my ummah is like the rain. My ummah is like the rain. I don't know which shower will be better, the first or the last. And I recognize now in my old age that that last shower of rain which is coming is going to come from the trail which was blazed by this scholar of great eminence, Maulana Dr. Muhammad Fazlur Rahman Ansari. I was blessed to be his student. It is his scholarship. It is his scholarship which will produce, which will, from which will emerge that last shower of rain, that scholarship which will dazzle the world in Akhiru Zaman. Mine is only a small effort. I'm just like a star to that moon in trying to prepare the world, prepare the way for an Islamic scholarship which is